requires discretionary viewer participation.
Welcome to another action-packed card of All-Star Wrestling promoted by Phil Zacco. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. The Deputy Commissioner is John Santoro. Attending physician is Dr. John Woods. Timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mickman. And your referees for this hour, Gilberto Roman, Dick Worley, and John Stanley. The first match in the ring is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, Captain Louis Albano. And his protege from Austin, Texas, 307 pounds, Cowboy Bob Duncombe. And his opponent, hailing from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 267 pounds, Dominic DiNucci.
Dominic DiNucci against the tough Texan. Here we go. DiNucci gets the ropes there, and the tough Texan surely is going to take advantage of every opportunity. He doesn't miss a trick, does he, Bruno?
No, he does not miss one single trick, and he's such a big, big man. You know, you look at Duncan here, he's about 6'6", 307, 310 pounds, and the guy can really, really move. He's fast, he knows wrestling, he's mean, he's strong. But of course, DiNucci, you know, Dominic is no slouch. We're talking about Dominic, who's about 6'4". He weighs 265, 270 pounds, and he can dish it out with anybody in the ring. And so this should be a really interesting bout, because Duncombe is going to be very aggressive. He knows how tough DiNucci is, so he's going to break every rule in the book. And on the other hand, DiNucci is well aware of this, so we'll see what preparation he has made for it.
Duncombe spinning around, trying to escape the side headlock. Trying to get behind DiNucci, going down on one knee, now trying to power his way out of it, spin around. Dominic staying right with him.
Do you want some of that?
Perhaps you can hear Goofy Lou Albano in the background. And you know, Albano being perhaps Bruno, the element that Dominic has accounted on here in this match.
He has got what, Vince?
Albano could be the element that DiNucci has not counted on.
Well, I'll tell you what, if Duncombe gets in any kind of trouble, you can almost bet that DiNucci will, Captain Albano will get involved. And of course, that does create a problem for Dominic, because here he's got a big man like Duncombe to deal with. And then, of course, you have to watch this lunatic from the outside and wonder what he's going to do.
Dominic shoved face first to the buckle. Dominic whipped to the far side now, and here comes! Oh, Bruno.
Did you just see that, Vince?
He had to break his shoulder.
I mean, he went through the ropes, and he went right against that steel post. I mean, he went right on his shoulder, all 307 pounds flying right against it. Amazing, amazing if he can continue with this bout.
But Dominic, surely taking advantage of the situation as well he should.
Well, Dominic, he knows what he's doing. He knows, he saw what happened. And knowing Dominic, he's going to stay on that arm as much as he can, and hopefully maybe he can get a submission out of it.
Oh, wow.
Oh. That Duncombe's got to be in pain.
But look at that. Now that tells you what kind of competitor Duncombe is. He fires right back. And you know that arm has to be hurting.
It's hurting him, and look at that. It just struck DiNucci, and then he's holding his own arm because it hurt him so. But he fights back. As we said, he's a mean, tough Texan. He's a big, powerful man.
Right hand knocking Danucci to the canvas. Is that a cover? Not much of one.
Duncan can really work on you if he gets you down on that mat. He knows how to use his weight, and he knows all kind of different, mostly illegal maneuvers on that mat that can really hurt an opponent, and he really knows how to hide him from the referee half of the time.
Duncan staying with it. And Danucci reaching for a hand. Look at that goof. What a goof.
Now this the way he's got like a claw on Danucci's neck. Now the way he's digging in, that's gonna be hurting Dominic quite a bit. And Dominic right now's gonna figure out how to get out of this situation.
Of course, the voice of Lou Albano may take a shot. Oh, yes.
What a cheap shot. That's Albano for you. Cheap shot. Look at this.
Albano back to take another cheap shot. That's too bad. You know, bad enough you're in there with a rule breaker like Duncan, but to have to contend with Lou Albano on the outside as well.
Well, you know, Dominic's got sometimes short temper too, and if he and he'll get out of this, if he gets the upper hand on Duncan and this lunatic is still around, don't be surprised if Danucci will get a few licks in there of his own, and I'd love to see it.
Dominic now again on the outside, but perhaps more prepared for Lou Albano. Dominic again, head first to the buckle, as we saw earlier in the contest. Whipped to the ropes, now hit it up. Duncan greets him with a kick in the upper chest. Dominic has taken all kind of punishment thus far. Oh, yeah. Duncan telegraphed that attempted back body drop. Dominic on top of him. And Duncan knocked through the ropes and to the outside. And Danucci's going right out there after him. You can't blame him.
Not a bit. And right now he's really got things under control with Duncan. But he's got to be careful of that count, because that count of 10 comes quick.
Count of 8. Count of 9. Oh, no. Lady Luck undoubtedly riding on the shoulders of Duncan here this week. Because Danucci belted Duncan through the ropes on the outside. Dominic went after him. But somehow, Duncan able to beat Danucci in for the count.
The time of the match, 7 minutes, 10 seconds. And your winner on a countout, Cowboy Bob Duncan.
That's too bad, it really is. Duncan, once again victorious. I'm sure Lou Albano, who had a hand in that match, is delighted with the outcome. We'll be seeing more of Dominic Danucci in the weeks to come. There's no doubt of it, and he certainly proved that he is every bit the competitor we always knew he was. We shall return in a moment.